Captain's log, stardate 47111.1. A Federation listening post along the Romulan neutral zone has detected an unidentified vessel headed for Federation space. The Enterprise is moving to intercept.
At its reported heading and velocity, the vessel will enter Federation space in approximately 47.3 seconds.
Go to yellow alert.
We have the vessel on sensors. The ship is a Garidian scout ship. They are driving their engines too hard. Their warp core is critical.
The Garidian? What is the status of their relationship with the Romulan Empire?
They're on friendly terms and may share technology.
We are being hailed.
On screen.
Help us. We are fleeing political persecution. We seek asylum. We are being hunted.
Their signal is breaking up.
What do you make of this, Number One?
It could be a trick.
The Garidians have earned a reputation as honorable warriors, Captain. They do not ordinarily resort to trickery.
We are within visual range. The Garidians' warp drive is failing. They are dropping sublight speed inside Federation space.
Slow to impulse.
Warper decloaking directly ahead. The Warbird is also Garidian. They are hailing us.
This is an internal Garidian matter. Withdraw at once.
You are violating Federation space.
They have cut off transmission.
The Warbird has locked its tractor beam onto the scout ship.
Go to red alert.
These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before.
Captain's log supplemental. A Garidian warbird has violated the neutral zone in pursuit of a scout ship. The fugitives may be seeking political asylum, but as yet we have been unable to confirm their intentions. What do you think, Number One?
The Garidians respect strength. If we show any sign of weakness, it might just encourage them to fight.
What do you suggest?
Maybe we can use our phasers until they listen to reason.
I don't want to provoke them, Number One. Mr. Worf, your analysis.
The Garidian Warbird is similar to the Romulan Dideridex class. It is less maneuverable than the Enterprise, but it has slightly more firepower.
We'd both take a beating if it came down to a fight.
Our records identify the Warbird as the Asirim, commanded by Captain Pintara. Starfleet intelligence rates her as a capable but unimaginative tactician.
Any insights, Counselor?
The Garidian captain is torn about something, as if she were faced with a difficult dilemma.
She has violated the neutral zone.
It's more than that. I think she has a personal stake in this matter.
Mr. Data, do you have any suggestions?
As long as the Warbird maintains a tractor beam on the scout ship, we cannot beam its crew aboard. However, if we maneuvered the Enterprise between the ships, we could temporarily disrupt the tractor beam.
We will have to drop our shield to use the transporter.
We'll have to take that risk. Make it so.
We have broken the Garidian's tractor beam.
The crew of the scout ship has been beamed aboard.
Captain, the Warbird is hailing us.
On screen.
Federation Starship, this is an internal Garidian matter. You've been warned not to interfere.
Surely we can resolve this matter without recourse to further violence.
They are locking their disruptors on us.
I will use violence if you do not cooperate, Captain. Transfer the criminals from the scout ship to my custody at once.
Whatever crimes they may have committed, you had no right to pursue them across the neutral zone.
I was sent to bring these criminals back dead or alive, and I will carry out my orders even if it means destroying your ship.
A Garidian ship is on sensors. We are being hailed.
No damage.
The shield I am holding. Torpedo away. Torpedo locked. We are being hailed.
You and I are not finished, Picard. I promise you that.
We have been hit. The Garidian ship has been destroyed.
Alert canceled. Condition green.
Captain, our new arrivals are requesting to speak with you. Their names are Lucana, Avakar, and Tabak.
What are your orders, Captain?
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
Captain Picard, can you help us contact a Vulcan archaeologist named Shaynok? He may possibly hold the key to the discovery of the Lawgiver's fifth scroll.
What is this fifth scroll you mentioned?
Let me give you a bit of background. Garidian society is a rigid structure consisting of two distinct classes, the patricians and the plebeians. For the past 1,000 years, that structure has been governed by the laws derived from the four sacred scrolls. The first scroll outlines our code of honor. The second describes the relationship between the military and the government. The third defines the principles of our religion. And the fourth enumerates the privileges and responsibilities of the patrician class.
But you speak of another scroll.
According to legend, the Lawgiver also wrote a fifth scroll defining the rights and privileges of the plebeian class, which were not explained in the other scrolls.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to. Perhaps we can talk again later.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Starfleet Command is still considering the options. While we review the situation, the Enterprise is to remain on patrol.
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
The Enterprise's presence in this region has set a lot of minds at ease, but I'm still concerned about the Romulan activity in the area. Look sharp, Captain.
What is the current situation, Admiral? Is there anything in particular we should be aware of?
Actually, things are relatively quiet right now. The only cause for concern is all the Romulan activity in the area.
Picard out. Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to. Perhaps we can talk again later.
Captain Picard, my name is Lucana. On behalf of the oppressed underclasses of Garrett, I'd like to thank you for rescuing us.
Don't thank me too quickly. You have illegally entered Federation space, and this ship is not a haven for criminals.
I am not a criminal, Captain. I am only seeking justice for my people.
Very well. You may stay on board the Enterprise until we have sorted this matter out.
Do not dismiss me so quickly, Captain. The fate of all Garrett is hanging in the balance.
Why do you say that?
I am searching for the fifth scroll. It's the only way to give the plebeians the freedom they deserve.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to. Perhaps we can talk again later.
Captain, we are receiving an emergency transmission from Simcoe 4.
Simcoe 4? Isn't there a research center there?
Yes, sir. The work at Merton's orbital station focuses on power generation. The researchers there are among the best in the Federation.
On screen. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise. How can we be of help?
Captain Picard? I am Deneb, Chancellor of Simcoe. We are in need of immediate assistance. Merton's orbital station has been attacked by an unknown vessel and does not answer our hails.
Attacked? But the station is a purely scientific facility.
Is the attacking vessel still present?
We do not know. Whoever or whatever they were, our sensors did not detect them.
Perhaps it was a cloaked Romulan vessel.
I doubt the Romulans would venture this far into Federation territory. The risks are too great.
Captain, you must hurry. The attack has destabilized the station's experimental power core. We don't know how long we have until a core breach, but I can tell you the resulting energy release and radiation would be catastrophic.
What about survivors? Did anyone get off the station?
We detected several escape pods, but we haven't recovered them yet. The pods we detected could hold only a few dozen. There are hundreds aboard the station, including families.
Set course for Simcoe 4. I hope it's not too late.
Thank you, Captain. I hope you arrive in time.
We'll do our best. Picard out. Dr. Crusher?
Crusher here.
Doctor, we may shortly be taking on a large number of wounded, possibly hundreds.
How much time have I got?
Not enough, I'm afraid. Picard out. Miss LaForge?
Yes, Captain.
We're en route to Merton's orbital station. They've been attacked, and they're going to need immediate assistance. See what you can find out about their experimental power core.
I'll see what I can dig up, but the Simconians do some advanced work. It may take a while to figure it all out.
Then I suggest you work quickly. Millions of lives on the planet's surface may be at stake. I expect a full analysis of the situation and our options as soon as we're within sensor range.
Yes, sir.
Engage.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
Captain's log. We have arrived at the Simcoe system in response to a distress call regarding Lurton's orbital station. The station was apparently attacked by unknown forces, leaving it in danger of a power core breach.
We are within sensor range of the Merton's orbital station, sir.
On screen. Miss LaForge?
LaForge here.
Report, what is the condition of the station?
You're looking at what's left of the Merton's orbital station, one of the largest research centers in the Federation. The focus of their work is on power generation. 5 years ago, they built the prototype of an experimental power core, and it's been running the station ever since.
Power generation studies? That doesn't warrant an assault like this.
I've been in contact with Starfleet headquarters. Power generation is only part of what this station studies. For several years, researchers here have been working on new ways to detect cloaked vessels.
If the Romulans discovered this, they might have risked a raid. The Simconians did not detect the attacking ship. It may have been cloaked.
That's speculation, Mr. Worf. We have no proof the Romulans were involved.
Well, whoever it was, something powerful punched through the station's shields and sliced off an entire research wing.
What do you mean, sliced off?
There is insufficient debris in the area to indicate that the missing section was destroyed. It is possible the attackers simply removed it.
Geordi, could that be what destabilized the power core?
No, and that's what I can't figure out. Damage to the upper deck should only cause minor problems, but I'm reading serious power fluctuations. Maybe serious enough to breach the power core's containment field.
What will happen if the containment field fails?
I can't say for certain, but with the amount of energy that thing can put out, I wouldn't want to be around it when it goes.
Is there any way to shut down the core?
There's a fail-safe mechanism which is supposed to jettison the core automatically in an emergency.
I'd say this qualifies as an emergency. Why wasn't the core jettisoned?
The only way to prevent it is by manual override. Someone has to be there to stop it.
That means there's someone still alive in there. Data, are you picking up any life signs?
The station's shielding is interfering with our sensors. I cannot tell if any of the crew are still alive. However, life support is still functioning. But power readings indicate that it may fail at any time.
Dr. Crusher?
Crusher here.
We are nearing Merton Station. Are you prepared for casualties?
My staff is ready to do double shifts. We can handle about 330 emergency cases, but we'll have to beam the rest down to Simcoe.
Understood. What is your recommendation?
We can't do anything from here, but to get an away team aboard, we have to find a way through those shields.
I believe I have a solution. The station's upper shields are badly damaged. If we establish a lock on a transporter on the upper decks, a transporter beam could penetrate the weakened shields.
Once we're in, we should be able to jettison the power core. Then we could lower the station's shields and evacuate the wounded.
Very well, Number One. Make it so.
Geordi, I want you and the rest of the away team ready to go in 20 minutes.
We'll be there in 10.
Beam down coordinates selected.
Power surges are serious. Without a stable power source, we'll lose life support. This is an unusual design for a transporter panel. These power surges are serious. Without a stable power source, we'll lose life support. Damage this station suffered, I'm surprised it's still holding together. It looks like she's still alive, but she's pinned under that cable. She's got two badly broken legs. We better get her a doctor.
All things considered, she's very lucky. I can take care of the worst of her injuries here, but I'd like to get her to sick bay.
With all the damage this station suffered, I'm surprised it's still holding together.
These data lines are pretty vulnerable. I'd be very careful about using a phaser to cut it.
Perhaps we could cut through the cable with a phaser.
We may be able to cut her free with a phaser, but we'll have to be very careful.
I can't cut any closer without endangering her.
I've been thinking about how to free that trapped crewman. What if we use the station's transporter to remove the cable? With the station's sensors out, we'll have to manually acquire the cable's coordinates for beaming.
It's a data transfer line. The end shows signs of contact with a phased energy beam.
This cable's built for handling information, not energy. I'm surprised it didn't just vaporize when it was hit.
I've got the coordinates for transport.
She's got multiple fractures in both legs. The bones in the lower part of her left leg are shattered. She's in shock and there's some internal bleeding. She's got multiple fractures in both legs. The bones in the lower part of her left leg are shattered. She's in shock and there's some internal bleeding. Takes care of the worst of her injuries. She's coming around now.
How do you feel?
I'll manage. You're from Starfleet, aren't you?
Yes, we're from the Enterprise. We just arrived.
Thank goodness you're here. I'm Anna Bennett, Chief Medical Officer. Listen, we've got a lot of wounded here. How many can you evacuate?
We can get everyone, but not until we lower the shield.
We can't do that until we stabilize or jettison the power core.
What happened here?
We were attacked, but I don't know who or what it was. I was headed for sick bay when something struck the hull and tore this cable loose.
Do you have any guesses who might have done this? Was there any warning?
We never knew what hit us. There was an initial attack which lasted maybe 10 minutes. Later there was a hull breach and the power systems went crazy. I don't remember anything after that. I passed out.
We'll be back to check on you later. Right now, we've got to stop the core breach if we can.
All right. I think I'll be fine for now.
Say we found our intruder.
It's sending false readings to our tricorders. It's like a chameleon. It disguises itself perfectly. If we weren't here to see it, we'd never know it was here. It could probably fool our ship sensors just as easily. This chameleon field seems to take a fraction of a second to adjust to new scanning frequencies. If I set the tricorder to randomly shift frequencies at high speed... There. I'm getting a partial reading now. Yep, it's a neutronium hull, all right, and a powerful energy source. I've never seen that much power in such a small package before.
It's Lieutenant Worf, the ship's security chief. It's Commander Riker. It's not working. Will's wounded.
I don't see anything special about it. I don't see anything special about it.
We have to get past that machine out there. It's blocking the way to primary engineering. Ideas?
We do not have sufficient weaponry to destroy the intruder.
What is it doing here?
It appeared to be drawing plasma from the third conduit cluster.
Well, that's it. It's collecting energy. Maybe if we can temporarily shut off the power, it'll leave.
Make it think the wells run dry, eh? It's worth a try.
There should be emergency shutoff controls around here somewhere.
Thank you.
A lot of these systems are out. I can still cut the power to any of the four conduit groups, but not for long. I don't want to overload the system. Enterprise, did you pick that up?
We have detected a small object departing the station at high speed. Sensors identify it as a small asteroid.
You've got to be kidding.
Apparently this object is capable of sending false readings to our sensors.
That asteroid is a sophisticated device. It's using a chameleon field to send false readings to the sensors.
Interesting. The object has accelerated to warp speed.
I'd like to chase it down, but the station isn't stable yet. See how long you can track it.
Acknowledged. Picard out.
You have an uncanny sense of timing.
What was that?
Timing, I said. You have fine timing. The one instant I cannot afford to be distracted, and in barges all of Starfleet.
There may be an auxiliary life support panel below in engineering. We could stabilize it from there.
I'm Commander Riker of the Enterprise. We've come to help.
Charm. I'm Dr. Silas Greaves, Chief of Energy Research. For now, the most help you can give me is to stay out of the way!
Our sensors show that your power core is unstable. We need to jettison it before it breaches the containment field.
Jettison it? No! This power core is inherently unstable. All we have to do is get it back within operating parameters.
There's no time to try and stabilize the power core. We have to jettison it now.
Very well. But this decision will be on your head.
I'd love to sit here and tinker with this thing until we get it stabilized, but we just don't have the time. There are wounded on this station that have got to be evacuated. Their lives have to come first.
Very well, then. The jettison controls are on the emergency panel right over there in the corner.
This will jettison the power core. Enterprise.
Picard here.
I'm getting ready to jettison the station's power core. Have a tractor beam ready to contain it and get it away from the planet before it goes critical.
Acknowledged. Picard out.
LaForge Enterprise, what's the station's condition?
The station's power core was just jettisoned. We've removed it to a safe distance with a tractor beam.
Good. You should be able to get a transporter locked now. Do you have us?
Yes. The station's shields were lowered when the core was jettisoned.
Great. That means we're done here. Beam us up.
Acknowledged.
We are being hailed, sir. It is Chancellor Daneb.
Well, I don't know how you did it, but thank you. The danger is past. Now all that remains is to pick up the pieces.
I regret that we were unable to save the station.
Please, no apologies. After all, some of the crew did make it out in the escape pods. We are simply glad to be alive. If that power core had not been jettisoned, I would not be here to thank you.
Take good care of your people, Daneb. We'll inform you as soon as we know who attacked the station.
Please do. There are accounts to settle. Daneb, out.
What are your orders, Captain?
Set course for the Ruinor sector and resume our patrol along the neutral zone.
Yes, sir.
Engage.
Thank you.